The Overland Track in Tasmania is Australia's most iconic wilderness trekking experience. 6 days, 65 kilometres in side trips, 100 kilometres all up, through the heart of the Cradle Mountain, Lake St Clair National Park. The weather was perfect when we got to Cradle Mountain's visitor centre, and we stayed overnight at Warheim Cabins near Ronnie Creek car park. Unfortunately, it rained at night and the fog was dense and visibility poor for our first day on the Overland Track. From Ronnie Creek car park, 960 metres, we had planned to walk to Lake Windermere on our first day, a total of 18 kilometres. However, the rain and heavy fog and strong winds meant that we only got as far as Old Waterfall Valley Hut, 10.7 kilometres. It was still raining for the start of the second day. At least visibility was better and the winds were calmer. 12 kilometres to Lake Windermere, taking a side trip to Lake Will. I'm looking up at where Bun Bluff, 1,559 metres, should be. There is only fog.
We're at Windermere Hut, and we're the first ones to arrive. So that means we can sleep inside. No tents tonight.
Day 3, Windermere Hut to Pelion Hut, 16.8 kilometres. Starting off with open buttongrass moorland, and then through Myrtle Beach rainforest and over the Forth River.
Ah, great to see the sun. It's the first time it appeared yesterday afternoon. You get a different energy when the sun is out. Hopefully the weather keeps like that for the rest of the journey.
Looking back at what we missed on the first and the second day, Bun Bluff on the left, Cradle Mountain on the right. Day 4, Pelion Hut to Kiora Hut. It's 25 degrees and clear skies, so that a side trip to climb Tasmania's tallest mountain, Mount Ossa, is a must.
Rest stop. Almost an hour of climbing has brought us to this point. And now the real climb starts. Another rest stop. The valley below. Let's see how far we've come. Amazing views. Follow the markers. Here's Tony, 70-year-old. A couple of the other blokes. And here's the summit.
Looking down at the Twin Towers, which I thought them to be the summit, and between them in the distance, Pelion East.
It's a little grassy knoll. There's a few rocks to commemorate where people have actually camped up on top of Mount Ossa. Oh, it just flattens out up the top. And there's the top. Hold on. Whew. Beat.
Great Tasmanian.
Tony the Great Tasmanian. And Joe. Top of Tasmania. Yep.
This is the valley we are headed down to, and this is the way we've come. Barn Bluff on the left, Cradle Mountain on the right.
That's it. You got to get under that rock.
On the right.
Just the legs don't feel the same way.
Day 5, Kiora Hut to Windermere Hut, with site trips to the three waterfalls, Ferguson, Dalton and Harnett. And today we will go from eucalypt forest to rainforest, back to eucalypt again.
I'm not sure to the French name or how you have to pronounce this thing, but doesn't matter. We're going now inside, have a look. Old style hut, I'm guessing. Wow!
Snake!
Thank you.
This is the sixth and the last day when you reach Hut to Narcissus Hut, and then catch the ferry to Lake St Clair. The easiest day on the track, a gradual, easy descent through eucalyptus forest and across button grass plains.